nasabi nila na due to technical. I think so. Sorry, before we proceed again, please turn on the, please allow the recording. Ayan, so pwede na po. Now, always remember that meron silang sinasabi na yung mga batang nag-50-50 daw, okay, after delivery. Now, that is basically correct. Okay, there are some patients who are delivered, especially yung mga newborns natin, that they become in danger after delivery. But according to research, when you breastfeed these children immediately after birth, what happens is we increase their chances of survivability by 13%. So hindi sila nag-50-50, nagiging 63-37 po yung chances of survival. So again, breastfeeding is very important because it increases their chances of survival. Bakit kaya? Marami pong rason kung bakit napakaganda yung mga breastfeeding sa ating mga newborn patients, and you will learn about them later on. Okay, sabi dito, a newborn is believed to be ready to be breastfed 20 to 30 minutes or even up to 120 minutes after delivery. So basically, that's 1 minute to almost 2 hours. Tama po ba? Okay, after delivery. So ibig sabihin, sa mga time na yon, after 20 to 30 minutes, ready na daw mag-breastfeed yung bata. That means to say that you have ample opportunity to open the airway, to thermoregulate the newborn, to properly time the cord clamping. So nagagawa mo na ito lahat-lahat bago pa magutom si baby. Alright? So after 20 to 30 minutes of thermoregulation, maintaining a patent airway, and clamping the cord, pag natapos mo yan, sakto, magugutom na si baby. So you can already start breastfeeding 20 to 30 minutes after delivery, or sometimes it can even extend up to 120 minutes after delivery. So yun po yung window of hunger ng bata. Okay? Now, always remember that during the delivery po, after delivery, I should say, when the mother is still inside the delivery room, yung bata po, we place them automatically on the chest of the mother, on the abdomen of the mother. Okay? So, habang hinihintay po yung breastfeeding cues, so papamagaan tayo deje ubingin, checkin tayo deje patent airway kada iklakram tayo deje cordon, sakto, malapit na po yung ulo ng bata doon sa source of breast milk. Okay? So, after 20 to 30 minutes, makikita na natin na magkakaroon na ng feeding cues yung bata, or bibigyan na niya kayo ng clue na siya ay nagugutom na. Alright? Now, while waiting for the feeding cues, ito yung mga signs natin para malaman natin kung gutom na yung bata. Alright? So, while waiting for the feeding cues, we should assess the newborn if they are breathing and if they are already warm. Excuse me, kwan naman po. Paki-on naman yung microphone nyo. Please tell me if naririnig nyo ako ng maigi or hindi. Or para raise your hands na lang po. Kasi yung baka nagkaka-technical difficulty daw. Can you hear me, Miss Lawson Y? Can you hear me? Naririnig ba ako ng maigi or hindi? Ay, nag-leave si Miss Law. Sandali lang ha, I'll just set
na-clear mo, sir.
Ah, na-clear po. Okay, salamat. Kasi may mga ibang nagsabi last time na hindi daw kasi ganun ka-clear. Alright, salamat. Okay na po. Alright. Now, like I said a while ago, habang hinihintay po natin yung feeding cues na ipakita ng newborn para malaman natin kung siya ay ready na to breastfeed, we should already start assessing if the newborn is breathing or if the newborn is warm. Alright? So, kasta ti itsura nati agbre breastfeeding, it's very good for infants, newborns, and even the father. Alright. Now, ano yung dapat tinitignan natin ay, like I said a while ago, during the time that you are waiting for the breastfeeding cues, is you have to listen for the grunting sound. So habang papamaga-MD ubing, habang iruray mo nga agbisinsuna, you have to listen for the grunting sound. Deto kaya dagi pinaganges na. Okay, dayo ubing. Deng game no dati garalgal na. Kung ganun ba mag-breathe yung bata. Because if the newborn breathes that way, that may mean that there is a problem when it comes to the respiration. Okay? You also look for chest indrawing and fast respiration. So, yung fast respiration, alam naman natin yun, di ba? If it's more than 60 okay, cycles per minute, that is already considered fast breathing. Alright? More than 60. Now, paano naman yung chest indrawing? Pag sinabi natin chest indrawing, it is a sign of difficulty of breathing po. No, dayday kumadeto yung ribs na dayo ubing niya. No, aganges isuna, agrise and fall dayjay abdomen na. But the but what happens in chest indrawing is that no detoy kumadejay ang ribs na okay no agangis isuna ke makunot detoy agpauneg. All right, I will send you a video of what chest indrawing looks like. So no agangis suna tas nakunoten na dejay ang ribs na pay nga agpauneg. All right, so those are the signs of difficulty of breathing kung meron tayong grunting sound, merong chest indrawing, or may fast respiration. There is a problem when it comes to airway and respiration. So isa yung tinitignan po natin while waiting for the feeding cues. Okay, tanuan mo tayo no mabisin din yung ubingan, i-check tayo yung breathing. The next thing that you have to check is warmth. Okay, like I said, it's also one of our responsibilities as a midwife to thermoregulate the newborn. So you check the temperature of the baby by using a thermometer. Or kung wala kayong thermometer available in the delivery room, you or kunwari pinanganak nyo si mother in the emergency area or nasa tricycle or nasa bahay na pinanganak nyo, you just touch the sole of the foot. Okay, rinain nyo lang jibukod mukod de ubing. And if the newborn's foot is cold, that means that he or she is suffering from hypothermia. So what do? You always keep the baby in skin-to-skin contact. Mabaling nga, you dry thoroughly the newborn, ulasam kininanang na, and place the newborn or give the newborn drop light and blanket and bonnet. So those are the things that you can do to thermoregulate the newborn. Pag siya ay giniginaw, pag malamig po yung sole of your foot or kung mababa yung kanyang temperature. Alright. So the next thing, pag habang hindi pa nagugutong si newborn or hindi pa natin nakikita yung mga feeding cues, the next thing that we can do is we can do routine procedures like weighing. So, syempre, no, hampi mabisin din yung newborn, mabalin yung alain din yung agundawa yen, taano, kitain, no? At kasanusuna kadagsen. So, you weigh the newborn and then you also take the anthropometric measurements. Alright? So, that the anthropometric measurements is the jirukudan yu dejayanti head circumference, chest circumference, abdominal circumference, total length, kung kunada. So, yun yon. So, pag nakuha nyo na yung dalawang yun at hindi pa gutom yung newborn, hindi pa siya nagpapakita ng signs of hunger, you can give them injection of vitamin K. Alright? So, your vitamin K or your phytomenadione prevents bleeding. Alright? So, nya pa iti mabalintay nga ited. No, matnuhan na ta mabisin. Mabalintay pa yung ited. And dejay, hepavaccine can BCG vaccine. Alright? But, if the newborn is breastfeeding, okay? If the newborn is breastfeeding, immediately, han yung ibagbaga nga, sir, alaim mi nga rodin, deto'y ubingin, tamakilo, ma-AP measurement, hindi po pwede yon. Alright? So, you only do that after the full breastfeeding cycle is complete. No, did you oneg ti delivery room, tarinugyan ko ma, did you ubing ti agkunoten, ti breast milk nan, you do not stop the breastfeeding cycle if it has not yet been completed. So, padiretsuan nyo latan nga, pagkunoten ang di ubing, and ingana mabmabsog, before you proceed to doing these procedures. Ngem no, you haven't seen those feeding cues yet, the next the thing that you can do is proceed to weighing, AP measurement, and vitamin K and other things like that. So I hope that is clear. Okay? Habang hinihintay po natin ang breastfeeding cues, pag hindi pa gutom yung bata, may naka-on po ang mic. Okay, pag hindi pa po gutom yung bata, you can start weighing, AP measurement, vitamin K, and vaccines. Ngayon, no, rugrug yan na tagsususon, you should not stop the breastfeeding cycle unless it is complete. Alright? Hamuhanga na importante apo dagita pinag-weigh kada pinag AP measurement niyem dejay diretso nga pinag breastfeeding na. I hope that's clear, okay? So that's how you take the temperature of the newborn. Alright, we also have the concept called latching on. Ano bang ibig pong sabihin when we talk about latching on? Ang term na pong ito, it means that this is the breastfeeding procedure that is done while the mother is still inside the delivery room, okay? Ito po yung tinatawag natin na early breastfeeding. So pag yung nakikita nyo sa picture, yung nanay po, nasa loob pa siya ng delivery, tinatanggal pa lang yung placenta, but the newborn is already breastfeeding. Ang tawag po dyan ay latching on or breastfeeding while the mother is still inside the delivery room. Maganda po ba to? Yes, may mga pros po ito, may mga positive effects po ito sa ating nanay at sa bata, which you will get to learn later on. Alright, so meron din po tayong tinatawag na subsequent feeding or feeding by schedule. Alright, so it's good that you are familiarized with the different terms which are connected to breastfeeding para merong nakaon ng mic po. Alright? It's good that you are familiar with these kinds of terms so that when we talk about things like this inside the hospital, at least makarelate kayo. Okay? So, amuyot at tanong niya tikay anasawin tila. Ching on, the next thing that we will learn is what subsequent or feeding by schedule means. Okay? So, pag sinabi na po natin subsequent feeding or feeding by schedule, this is a method of breastfeeding or feeding the newborn or infants every 2 to 3 hours. Okay? Deto, ihanta yung iura yan nga agbisin di ubing. Papadegenta yung insigidan every 2 to 3 hours. That is what you call feeding by schedule. So, if you look at the picture here right now, DJ pinagpasusunak is 2 a.m., 5:30 a.m., 6:30 a.m., 8:50 a.m., 10:50 a.m. So that is what you call subsequent feeding. We do not wait for hunger signs or breastfeeding cues sabay tayong apatid dyan. Ligyo newborn, pinapa-dede na natin siya every 2 to 3 hours. So subsequent feeding or feeding by schedule. Meron din tayong tinatawag na concept of demand feeding. Okay, coming from the word demand. Okay, kaya na. Kaya, kotig deden, kunana, listen, sugar tits, when I say I'm hungry, that means I'm hungry now. Kunana, reji ubing ji picture. So when we talk about demand feeding, this is the breastfeeding the baby whenever the baby cries or shows breastfeeding cue. So dito po wala tayong sinusunod na schedule. Ang sinusunod lang po natin dito ay padedehin yung newborn pag siya ay umiiyak or padedehin yung newborn kung nakakakita tayo ng breastfeeding cue. Alright, so magpapakita naman ng breastfeeding cues si newborn, wag po kayong mag-alala, and you will learn these different breastfeeding cues later on. Meron din tayong tinatawag na supplement feeding or supplementary feeding. Okay, itong supplementary feeding naman, we only start this during the 6th month of life. Alright, so ibig sabihin niyan, the newborn will not anymore be contented with breast milk alone or bottle milk alone, hanga mabalinan nga puro gatas laeng tea, kang kanin na rin ubing yan pag siya ay 6 months old na. Now, in your supplementary feeding, always remember po that the breast milk that the newborn is getting from the mother is low in the mineral called iron. Nababati iron na dejay. Okay, apaya. Dejay nga min breast milk, awan talaga ti iron nga maala dejay. So, supplementary feeding or supplementary food is needed to prevent iron deficiency anemia. Tagamin na digi ubing, hanta yung ikanti other sources of food na like kumadagita fruits, vegetables, nalusak-lusak nga saba, kadaam. Nuhan yung ikanti kas jay, 6 months nan, 2 years old nan, breast milk latta. Okay naman, pero magkakaroon siya ng iron deficiency anemia kasi nga wala pong iron yung breast milk. Alright? So, those are the terms related to breastfeeding. Next, Ano ba yung mga breastfeeding cues natin? Paano natin po malalaman if the newborn or the infant is already hungry? No, damagin tayo kadagi dyan ng nanang deje, tibagada, misis ka sa nung nga mamam no mabisinan deje anak mo. Agsangit, sir. Tama naman sila? Tama. Pwedeng tama din sila. But that is already a late sign of hunger. Nalabesen tibisinan, dejay malataga, dejay newborn, no, samla pa pakanin, so na no, agsangit. Alright? So, ano ba yung mga breastfeeding cues talaga na meron dapat dapat natin tinitignan? Number one is there is eye movement under closed eyelids. Nung nakaidda, dejay ubing ko mga mamaturog, agaraw-garaw dejay yung timatana. Okay, garaw-garaw dejay yung timatana. Ibig sabihin, that is a breastfeeding cue, may restlessness yung newborn, kaya ibig sabihin, siya ay nagugutom. Laglagipin nyo nga newborns can drink or eat even if they are asleep. Alright? So, kung makita yung garaw-garaw dyan yung mata na dyan yung ubingin, kung na yun, misis, padedeemon, deta, anak mo mabisinin. So, that's one breastfeeding cue. Eye movement under closed eyelids. Number two is we also have alertness. Movements or flailing of arms and legs. No, deji ubing, garaw nga garaw. Okay? Garaw nga garaw deji newborn. Kaya nasa wendeta is mabisin. Always remember that the newborn, especially on the first 28 days, deta ket mangmangan ken maturog lang tubraen na. Alright? Agreeing deta ta no lang mangan. So ano alert deji ubing. No, siririing deji ubing. Kaya nasa wendeta mabisin. No, garaw nga garaw di makinsaka na kaya nasa wendeta mabisin. So that's the time that you breastfeed the newborn. Ang kasi ka mang breastfeed ay bagam kininanang. Okay, misis, pasuswemon ko nang baka kay dirwar mo ta susumon madama duty ko pa dedikan to medi giant. All right. If there is also tossing, turning and wiggling. Okay, deta dige. Ala api yung gumarawan detoy anak ko kung kanada. All right? Ibig sabihin lang po noon nagutom na yung newborn. Okay? There is also mouthing, agnganganga, licking, agdilpa-dilpa. Okay? Tanging, sanasanap-sapen na dejay dila na. That's what you call tanging movement. Kunakunana, alright? Those are breastfeeding cues. Rooting. Pag sinabi nating rooting, ito po yung reflex na if you touch the side of the cheek near the corner of the mouth, no, sa gidem deto yung aparte, sangwen ni newborn deta. Okay? Sangwen na deta. That's what you call rooting reflex. Pag tinatch mo ditong side na to, okay, dito sa cheek, sangwen ni newborn deta. Rooting reflex, okay? Apay nga dati rooting reflex, tagamin the newborn's eyes cannot yet see. Alright? Kasi nung nangod mabirukan di nipple because of the rooting reflex. No, isagid-sagid ni nanang di yanti nipple, dito yanti cheeks na, the newborn will turn to that direction. So nga na insagid-sagid ni nanang deta nga nipple or deta nga imanan kuma sinango de ubing nagkunot, rooting reflex, ibig sabihin gutom na po yung bata. So pwede na po siyang padedehin. Next, there is also change in facial expression. Okay, agkusi-kusilap, nagigrimace yung bata. Api nga tanga kasta, kasla uncomfortable, kasla makasangsangitin, kasla irritable, deta rupa na. If there is a change in facial expression, then basically, yung bata po ay medyo nasasaid na siya sa gutom. Okay? Dandanin ag sangit deta. Okay? Narugyan nanti ag create this squeaking noises. Nga, nga, nga. Sa baboy ko mga baboy ng agsisqueak. Okay? Nga, nga. Pananan. Or light fussing. Okay? That means that newborn's hunger is intensifying. Ngayon, noha mo nga pinansin, dagito yung early stages or early signs of a breastfeeding hunger, it means na mag-proceed siya sa crying. So pag iiyak yung bata, that goes to show that the newborn's hunger is already in the extremes. Crying is a late sign of hunger. So sabihin po natin sa mga magulang na hindi po tama yung hihintayin pa yung bata para umiyak bago natin sila padedehin. You have to teach the mothers, especially the first-time mothers, about these different breastfeeding cues so that they will not be dependent on the teachings of the older generation. Nga ibagada, naisa ka dalang agpasuso dapat, no? pagsangsangit ni ubing. Dapat i-erase na po natin yung knowledge na yon. Alright? So I hope that you, the breastfeeding cues have been cleared up. So sana po ay clear na sa inyo yung mga palatandaan kung paano natin malalaman that the newborn is already hungry. So what is your problem? Kung nanonina lang na kumain, I'm hungry! Kung na medyo ubing. Alright? So again, crying is the late sign of hunger. Now, how do we initiate, okay, breastfeeding? Especially sa mga first-time mothers po, mahirap po sa kanila ang mag-start ng breastfeeding cycle. Ado ti irasun dagidyan ang nanang, especially dagidyay, handa kayat di ibagada nga agyudayo do dito susukun, bagada to nga, magsasag yung susuk kasi isutin bagada dagidyay kakabagyan minga-minga nalpas nga nag nagsiksikugen, yakayat nga agsag dejay, ang kukay agpasuso. So, mahihirapan sila kasi marami silang mga beliefs na naririnig, okay? Or judgment regarding the process of breastfeeding. Awan rumor, sir nga, tubog ti susok, sir, bulsek de ti susok, kung kanada, adu ti rasun na. So, we have to assist the mother during the early stages of breastfeeding initiation. That is our one of our midwifery responsibilities. So, again, paano ba natin siya isi-start dapat? Always remember that health workers should not touch the newborn unless there is a medical indication. Okay? Anong ibig sabihin nito? Nagsususulid yung ubingin. Okay? You do not need to touch them. You do not need to interrupt their feeding session. Okay? No agsususo laki di nga makita yo. But if the newborn kunwari is naka amal, di yan tisusong yung nakita da nga may meron palang problema, meron palang kailangan na gawin. Like for example, the newborn had meconium staining, yung na amalan na may isuso. That's the time that you can interrupt the breastfeeding for deep tracheal suctioning. So again, kung wala naman pong problema at nagsususo na or nagbe-breastfeed na yung bata, you do not interrupt the feeding session, right? You have to remember that. Next, I also tell the parents that it is a no-no to give sugar water. At dagamin na gijina do mga babaket, kada nananang nga kunada, painumem ti danum nga dati asukar na, tanu na pigsan to, tanu na kired kunada. That's wrong. Okay? We do not give sugar water anymore. Ano pa? If the newborn is born in the hospital, hindi din po pwede ang formula milk or bottle milk. Medyo matemplang agatas like Promil S26 kadaglalok. Hindi po pwede yon. Okay? And other pre-lacteals, yung mga agatas-gatas po dyan na nititimpla, hindi po pwede. Why? Because we are regulated by the law called Executive Order No. 51 or EO51. Okay? It regulates the use of milk and milk products in the hospital. So again, no makita tayo nga adda ti bote, ti gatas, ti jay, we confiscate them. Right? We confiscate these bottles, these milk products that are given to the newborn. Bakit? Because as midwives, we have to be advocates of breastfeeding. So hanga mabalindag gid rason na rason nga sir deto gamin susok ke bulsek, may mga work around po tayo diyan. We can do several things to prevent that from happening or solve that problem. Right? So again, hindi po pwede, walang exemption po ang pagbibigay ng sugar water, formula and other pre-lacteals. Lahat po dapat we encourage them to do breastfeeding. Right, so like I said, only breastfeeding is allowed because it is our responsibility as the midwife to become breastfeeding advocates. Next, it is also not good to give bottles, okay, or pacifiers, especially if they are still newborns, okay? Sir, kasano kimbaga met nga mabalinti pacifiers tagijay lalo no infancy? Yes, infants pwede po. Pero during neonatal period, on the first 28 days, hindi pa po tayo nagbibigay ng mga oral stimulants. Dapat yung oral stimulant lamang niya ay ang suso ng nanay. Alright? Next. You also tell the parents to not throw away the colostrum. Alright? The colostrum, ito po yung first breast milk that is produced by the mother. There is a belief of older generations that colostrum is spoiled milk na bangles nga gatas. So nga kunadag jilululang yu, kuno tem deta susu deta laka ay deta bake mo ta ito pram kinabangles deje nga gatas deje puraw kunada. That's wrong. All right? The colostrum is not spoiled milk. Kaya po ganun yung color ng colostrum, medyo nag-yellow pa siya or medyo nag-clear pa siya yung color. So, ano bang color ng gatas? Di ba puti? Okay? Kaya gaputa sa balit itsura na deji colostrum, ibagada gaje ba bakit nga nabangles nga gatas dito. That is not correct. Bakit po? Because colostrum is very important to be eaten or drunk by the newborn because it contains immunoglobulins that protect the newborn. Dito yapo immunoglobulins are the same as your vaccines kasi nasa una bakuna which will prevent common coughs and colds. Okay? Nagita tayo ma-protection na dito colostrum. So, napintas nga matilmun dapat dito yung deji ubing kasi pampatangken ti kired, pampalakas ng resistensya yung first breast milk of the mother, which is called colostrum, right? So it contains immunoglobulins that protect the newborn. Next, always remember that we let the baby feed for as long as he or she wants on both breasts. Okay? No, agsususulat ta, kayat nalatatig dadedahin yung iba ganun, nasubra amon tinanganan, hindi po. May mga automatic pong switch on and off yung mga bata. Alam po nila kung sila ay gutom na, gutom pa or busog na, they will automatically stop, okay, breastfeeding or sucking if they are already full. Ngayon habang agdedede pa lang deta kaya nasawin hampay ng anak neck. All right, so let the baby feed for as long as he or she wants. Aside from that, sinabi din dito, let the baby breastfeed on both breasts. Dapat duwa nga suso tipakunutan. Why? Because it will help relieve engorgement. Pag sinabi po nating engorgement, ito po yung sobrang paglaki ng suso dahil sa sobrang dami ng gatas na laman, okay? Gaputa na gaduti karga na deta nga gatas deta nga suso, mabennat su na nga mabennat. Hinaga na deta kit engorgement. In Ilocano, we call that agdigges. Or in some dialects, it's agtigges kunada. Alright? Ag-overflow pa di yan ti gatas and rumrumara pa iti dadu mga tubog ti susunan. Painful daw yon para sa mga magulang. Okay? Now, apisir nga nagkakaroon ng engorgement kasi hindi natatanggalan ng laman yung suso. So what do we do to relieve this feeling of engorgement, this feeling of discomfort? Pagsuswim di yung ubing on both breasts. Alright? So sometimes, nagkakaroon din ng mastitis yung mga babae. When we say mastitis, it means infection of the breast. All right? Infection or inflammation of the breast. Kasi ano nga mapaspasamak dito yung mastitis gamin? When there is engorgement, di ba? DJ susum, kinaben natin, gaputa, aduunay ti danum, ay ti danum tuloy. Aduunay ti gatas na. Okay? So gaputa, aduunay ti gatas na DJ nga suso, tahami nga may kikatanin, pwedeng nagkakaroon po ng tearing doon sa mga nipple area, agsugat-sugat deta, and that can also lead to infection. Alright? So nga, the only way that we can prevent engorgement and mastitis is to prevent ano, yung paglaki ng suso because of ano, lack of breastfeeding. Okay? So dapat pagsuswenta yung pagsuswenta yung ubing, taano mapreventaran detoy engorgement and mastitis. Alright? So, when the mother is initiating her breastfeeding, nura damo na palang tigpasuso, it is your responsibility as a midwife to help the mother and the baby in a comfortable position. Dapat kitidjay da komportable nga position at ano, very, very enjoyable melaing di first experience na together as mother and child nga agbre breastfeeding. Di ba nagmadimi nagpapasuso ka kung matapos ang nanapin na si position mo, matangan ka, there is a high chance that the mother will not want to breastfeed anymore. Kunada, kaya itigpasuso, makatang ko na nito. So it's your responsibility as a midwife to help them assume a comfortable position during breastfeeding. Aside from that, you also have to observe the newborn. Okay? Always observe the newborn. No, mapangkaig vital signs, ti nanangkin na yung ubing, ikit-kita yung yung ubing. Alright? You look at the newborn. Once the newborn shows signs of feeding cues, ask the mother to encourage the newborn to move towards the breast. No, agdilpa-dilpa tayo ubi niya na kikunamon, misis. Iyasideg mo deta susumun ka ni baby, taanurog yan nanti ag kunot tigatas. So that's what you use the breastfeeding cues for. Dahil iti pangiyusaran nyo, dahil nga knowledge yo. Okay, so makita yung nga, agpakita ti breastfeeding cues tayo ubing, you encourage the mother to start breastfeeding. Alright. Alright. May mga late tayong dumating. Alright, we also have Republic Act 7600. Pag sinabi po natin RA 7600, ito po yung kinatawag natin na Rooming In and Breastfeeding Act of the Philippines. Okay? Pijin mo natatay, EO 51. Okay? Yung Executive Order 51, it prevents the use of bottle or formula milk inside the hospitals, and it also regulates other milk products in the country. Dito met RA 7600, ito po yung law na nagsasabi na hindi po pwedeng ma-separate yung bata at saka yung nanay when they are still inside the delivery, ay, when they are still in the hospital. Dati-dati kasi, after the delivery of the mother, we immediately get the newborn and take them to the neonatal ICU. Pag sinain min, sabali ti papanan na di ubing, sabali ti papanan ni nanang mapantumit di obigay ni nga warden. Ngayon po, because of the Rooming In Breastfeeding Act of the Philippines or the RA 7600, hindi na po pwede yon. After delivery, the mother is moved into a stretcher with her baby and they are transported in their room. Anong ibig sabihin nito? The mother and the child will stay in one room. Apay gamin. Hindi gamin apo kaya narigat ti pasuswen dagijay nanang, dagijay anak da, especially if they are in the NICU. Di ka di? Malagid pula unay when I was still a student, agayab kami idi pamisundo and deji kami NICU nga nakajutig, sang sangit ko medyo ubing, mapaminto pa lang dagdagasin ni nanang na, dijay anti obigay ni ward. Nakabaybayag po pa ilaing nga kwa, magnaninanang na, santo, pasuspend na rin yung ubing. So, sobrang kakaasi dagit yung newborn CD. But now, that is not anymore a problem because the newborn stays already with the mother in their own room. Alright? So, non-separation po of the newborn and the mother ang sinasabi ng RA 7600. Alright? Sorry? Next? You also have to remember that positioning for the newborn during breastfeeding is also essential. Napaka-importante po na malaman natin as midwives kung ano yung proper position para po may-advise natin ito sa mga nanay, right? So always remember that the newborn's neck is not flexed or twisted during breastfeeding. Dapat, did you, tingid din yung ubing kitang nakakasta. Ang nakakasta, nagpapasuso, dapat diretso laing po, it is not flexed. Alright? So makita yung jitengid na nakaposition na siya. At apay, no nakakasta po, narigating tilmo, no nakakasta, narigigat man yung tiag, tilmunin. Alright? So the newborn's neck should not be flexed or not twisted during breastfeeding. Alright? Madami po ang ating mga classmates. Next! The newborn should also be facing the breast. Nakasanguso na dapat ti jayanti susunga kunutin na. And the newborn's body is close to the mother's body. No, agarako, no, nidiyo ubing dapat nakadikit met ka dejay bagi ni nanang. Alright? So, facing the breast, the neck is not flexed or not twisted. Ano pa? The newborn's whole body is supported by the hands of the mother. Okay, nakakasta dapat ni nanang. Okay, ano pa? Alaglagipan niyo pa yung apong nga dito yung picture na correct latching on. Kitain niyo nga, dito yan ti bibig, dito ubing, dito yan ti lower lips na, they are flanged out. Kunada, nakakasta. Okay, kasi dito lower lip, dito ubing, ti mangi durun, dito gatas nga, mangi pangato. Because always remember that there are tubercles of Montgomery, dito paggapuan ti gatas on below the on the lower part of the breast. DJ nga pislen, DJ ubing, using the lips, taano rumar, DJ gatas. Alright? Ano pa? Mas marami ka dapat nakikita na areola on the upper part kesa sa lower part. So, naadado dapat, adada nga naamalan na DJ ubing, DJ nakimbaba nga para titi, suso. That's how the correct latching on position is. Alright? So, dito yun, DJ, proper mouth attachment, ibagbaga tatayan. The mouth of the baby should always be wide open during breastfeeding. Hanga dapat nga kastalang ti pinagkunot na di ubing. Dapat wide open. Nakanganga nga permi, inammalan na nga permi dejay nipples. Ano pa? The lower lip should be turned outwards or flanged out. Yung kunada nakakasta. Okay? The lower lip ni newborn. Aside from that, the baby's chin should be touching the breast. Okay, dito'y timid na dapat nakasidag ka digi suso ni nanang. And the sucking motion should be slow. It should be deep and with some pauses. Aping nga masapol nga pause digi ubing. Agtilmon. Kunana. Okay, slow and deep. Nauunik dapat digi pinagkunot ng himno. Agkunot digi ubing nga. Kunana lang apo haan nga ususto digi nga latching on. Right? Hanga naka-attach nga na siya at digi ubing. Paslamit lang data charger. Di ba naman mga naidugsul nga na siya at di charger ka di cellphone mo ke awan ti mag na nga kuryente when ha nabuntog na ag-charge. So that is the same with your proper attachment during breastfeeding. Aside from that, remember na maganda po na we promote proper attachment during breastfeeding because it prevents occurrence of colic. Pag sinabi po natin colic, it is abdominal distension which is caused by swallowed air. Gapu apu ta, no, napangit ti attachment na, agkungkunot di ubing, nga ti mapasamak is makatilmunso na ti angin. Gapu di jay nga madinga attachment na from the nipple or from the breast. Di jay nga pinakatilmun na ti angin, mapunun tumitin ti angin di jyannan, anginen tun. Ang English po ng anginen is called colic or kabag naman in Tagalog. So ngano pitikem dejayan ti chan deju ubing kasla drum. Okay, that's what we call adventitious sound. Napunno aminen aputi angin deji chan nan so nga nasakit dejay. So that is what we call proper attachment. So makita yun nakadakkel jing nga ju ubing, di ba? Dakkel jing baba ju ubing deji chin na nakadeket kadejay breast ni mother. That's what we call proper mouth attachment. All right. Now, after breastfeeding, you always have to do burping. Okay? Pagtag-aben nyo di ubing. Apay. Kasi hindi po maiiwasan na makakaswallow pa rin siya ng air. So, the baby should be burped to expel swallowed air because always remember po na milk is also gas-forming. It is a substance that when it is digested in the body, nagproproduce po ng gas yan. Alright? So, ngayon nag-tag-up ka pa ino, uminom ka kanuti, gatas. So, what can you do is you have to burp the baby after feeding. So, kasanutin ko braan dito eh. The baby is positioned, resting on the shoulder. So, kitain nyo the yubing ne, di dyan ti abaga ni nanang. Okay? Nakapatay di dyan ulo na. And then, you also have to give light back tapping on the back of the newborn. So, pik-pik-pikan yung medyo likod na. And it should be done 15 to 20 minutes after feeding. Dejay apo, ti kapintasan nga time nga, pinagpa-burp tayo, dejay ubing. Hami nga, kalkalpas nga nagsusuki, apo, pinag-burp mo. Kung kuna, pik-pik-pikan mo. Agsarwa, dejay yan, ah. So, iuray mo pa yung agsamay, dejay. Tinilmun na nga gatas. So, you should wait for 15 to 20 minutes after feeding. And then you do position the baby for burping. So by positioning them on their shoulder, on your shoulder, konakoma, and then giving them light back tapping. So that's what we call burping. Next, breastfeeding initiation. Ang pinakamaganda pong ginagawa natin is we have to look for a quiet place. No, irugi tayo ti agpasuso or irugi ni nanang tigpasuso. Make sure that you take them to a place with less distraction. Okay? Quiet place po dapat. Especially pag first-time mothers, ito po yung pinakamahirap, yung i-establish po ninyo yung first-time na breastfeeding. So you have to place them on a quiet place para makapag-concentrate both mother and the newborn. Next, you have to find the most relaxed position for the mother. Kaya natigidda, kaya natigtugaw, kaya natigtaader, ano yung position niya pinaka-comfortable niya before you start breastfeeding initiation. Next, you also provide proper back support to both mother and the child, okay? Make sure na medyo ubingket, napsuportaan nga na siya at jilikod na, and make sure nga ni mother kit hanga kakaasing agbagkati, ubing, by giving them back support. So, misis, agsanggir ka ka deto yun eh, natugaw ko na ayo. Alright? Next, you also support the feet of the baby para hindi siya nagdadangle, kasi nuhan yung suportaran gisa ka ubing, agdangdangle to suna di jayan, agbitin. Okay, and also do not scissor hold the breast to prevent the blockage of the lactiferous ducts or lactiferous tubules or tubercles of Montgomery. Okay, so kasanti pa mayan tayo detoy. I-scissor hold niya ko na dahil kastoy. No, dahil kung magisuso, makita dami lang. No, dahil kung magisuso, scissor hold ko na dahil kastada na eh. Ikastada dahil joy suso. Hindi po ganyan yung dapat na ginagawa pag magpapa i-initiate ng breast feeding. Kasi pag ginaganito mo ito, you're blocking the lactiferous ducts which are located on the bottom part of the breast. No, ikaskastoy mo. Hanga makunot de jay ubing de jay. So what can you do is you can raise the breast here, guyudan nyo ditoy, when ho ani, durun nyo from the bottom. Okay, when nyo inapimpinas ni guyud na ito de jay ngaton. So that's what we call scissor holding de jay ikastada. Scissor hold. Nagets po ba? Alright. Next, we have to study the different holds that are available po for the newborn and the mother, okay? Ito po yung cradle hold na tinatawag natin. The cradle hold is the classic breastfeeding hold. If the baby nursing on the right breast should be supported using the elbow of the right hand. So imagine, dito yung kumadidyo ubing, agsusususo na dito, dito yung ulo na. Okay, right breast, timang support dapat juulo na is the elbow of the right hand. Maget, so ikas jayo, dito juulo juubing. Cradle position, dito ju normal apo nga uso sarenda nga pagpa suso. Alright, so the head of the newborn should rest on the right crook of the right arm nga pagpapasusman na nga right breast. Okay? Now, this is best for term babies, nagigidadakkelen, okay? Pustutis sukat na, titimbang na, which are delivered via NSD. Pinakamaganda po itong cradle hold na to. As you can see on the picture, nadaras lang, di ba? Igamamidjay, samudigimesang imam, suportaran metanjay, sakana. That's what we call the cradle hold. We also have the cross cradle hold. Yung cross cradle hold naman po, it is also known as your crossover hold. Okay? If the baby is nursing on the right breast, dito ti pagsuswan na, di ka di, and then dito yung ulo na, use your left hand, to support the baby's head, and then deji met mesa nga imam, deji right hand mo, it should be holding the lower extremity. Makita yung met kadeta picture. Again, imagine nyo nga dito yung mic, dito yung ulo yung ubing. Cradle hold, kunata yun, dito yung sunang agsususo, ipang ko yung imak dito, and then dito yung mesa nga imak, igama dito yung saka na. This is what you call the cradle hold. Cross cradle hold met apo, no dito yung ulo yung ubing, agsuso ka dito yung suso, dito yung left nga imam ti usarem. Right? So kasta met ti cross cradle hold. Okay. Nung niya tipagsuswan na, jibangir nga imati, mang subsuporta jay, ulo. Kasta titsura nati, cross cradle hold. So sir, para kanino po ito maganda? This kind of position or hold is best for babies who are small. Especially tagi preterm, kada tagi small for gestational age, nga kunada, tagi babasit, pinakamaganda po yun. So kaya lang asing single-handed ni nanang, nga, kasi babasit da. Okay? And for infants who have trouble latching on. Alright. Taano, deji mesa nga ima ni nanang, mabalin nga iso timang guide ka deji suso na kasi deto iti makanawidan na. Di ka di? Alright. So that's what we call the cross cradle hold. Nakita met na nga na siya at deji in demo when no hanga na allergy camera. Can anyone turn on the microphone and tell me if you got the concept correctly? Miss Valera, paki-on naman po yung mic and tell me kung nakuha po yung concept. Nakita da may lang winuhan or anyone from the group?
Did you cradle hold, sir?
Did you cradle hold?
Did you lang mic nakita sa cross cradle, sir?
Okay. Yung cross cradle hold lang tinakita. So the black, ah, hamo pa ibababa, Miss Valera. Makita nga na siya atin?
Okay, sir.
Okay. Did you cradle hold niya kunada? So deti ti ulo, did you ubing? Deti ti pagsuswan na nga suso, right? Okay? Deto yung met dapat nga elbow ti mang support. Deti yung ulo, yung ubing niya, suso di toy. Deto yung dapat ti mang support. Itura na makita yo. Alright. Okay. Did you met cross cradle hold nga kuna tayo? No, deto iti suso nga pagsuswan na, deto yung ulo, yung ubing, deji banger nga imam ti mang suporta yung ulo na. Alright? So, nagsuso di yung ubing, deji right pagsuswan na, di left nga imam ti pag igamam, pagigem mo yung ulo na, and then deji mesa ti pagigem jay saka. That's what we call the cross cradle hold. Nakuha po ba? Kaya na po? Alagaro, di ba namin dumay ka naman? Okay, naariwawa. Okay, thank you so much. Let's proceed. Alright. Ang next pong position natin is what we call the football hold or the underarm hold. Dito po, the baby is tucked under the armpits like a handbag or a football. Kaya po siya tinawag na football hold or underarm hold. Kasi basically, dito'y kilikiliti mangigem ka dito ubing. Okay? This is best for cesarean section mothers. Apay, tagamin, di ba dagay cesarean section? Kita dati sugat dito'y tsanda. Alright? No, dati sugat na dito'y, no, kasto'y da ngagigem, nasakit, masagit dejay, sugat da. Cross cradle man when no cradle hold, matandagan lahat na ubing dejay, sugat. So, hindi po maganda yon cross cradle and cradle hold for cesarean section mother. Ang pinakamaganda po ay football or underarm hold because it avoids the pressure on the incision area. It is also best for babies who have trouble latching on because the hold allows the woman to readjust the breast. Okay? Ano pa, maganda po din ito for women with very large breast, lalo no tagi dadakkel ti suso nga babae, di ba? Apo handa nga ma arakop nga na siya at tagi anak da at aglulupyas met ti suso da kinadakkel nan. Okay, narigat para kanya da dayjay. So pinakamaganda po sa kanila ay football hold or cross your underarm hold. It is also best for twins kasi nagpasuso ni nanang mapagiddanda nga pasuswen tagi anak na kasi no nya tigsususo nga agsususo nga parte nga suso isumit ni mga supporta jay ima. I will show you. Miss Tolosa, please turn on your microphone. Tell me no nakita mga na siya at. Alright. Now, ganito po ang itsura. Okay? Baring makita yung may ilangan na siya at. Dito yung ulo ti ubing, agsususo na ka, dito yung right nga suso. Dito yung right nga ima. So what do? You place the head of the newborn here. Right? And then the newborn is placed on the breast and then iipit yo de jayanti saka na in your underarm. Sayo isupport de jay ulo na. Magets? Ganyan po yung itsura ng underarm or football hold. So nga kasla, pagigigim di football, nga makikita yo de jay sinan itlog tibula na nga color brown, parang ganun yung itsura. So, football hold. Nakita mo lang ay hansang awan sa mic na ni Miss Taloza. Miss Valera, nakita po ba yung video? Ay yung itsura. Okay, sige. Salamat. Sige. I-off mo muna yun. Sumarunong nga topic tayo is your side lying position. Itong side lying position, sobrang dali lang to. Amuyo amin deto yan no kasanong ubrain. In your side lying position, it is also known as the reclining position. Both the mother and the newborn are lying in bed. Duwada nga nakaida. Side lying position. With pillows on their back. Maikanti pungan di jay likod ni nanang, maikanti pungan di likod jubing, and then both of them will face each other. The baby's head is then cradled for support. So makita yung met niya ni mamang, subsuportara na di jay, ulo di jubing. Api sir, sino dapat ang gumagawa nito? This is best for mothers who are recovering from cesarean section. Lalo dagi jay nananang ko mga under the influence of anesthesia pa lang, maulo-ulo do pa lang, handa pa lang makabangon, handa pa lang makatugaw, they can already start breastfeeding by using the side lying position. Okay? Ano pa? Mothers who have difficulty sitting down, okay, dagi jay na CS nga road, or for mothers who are breastfeeding at night, okay, nagpasusuda, trabrabi, handa man sa apulin, tibumangon, apay, tagaminket, mabalindang ubra in the side, lying position. Okay, so very comfortable po. Now, kaya ko po itinuro itong mga bagay na ito sa inyo because you have to adapt to the different situations of the mother when you are taking care of them. Laglagipin nyo nga adadagijay positions that are best for CS, best for normal yung weight ng bata, best for mothers nga dakil susuna, basit susuna. So it's up to you as midwives to use this knowledge so that you can advise the parents on how to properly hold their newborns during breastfeeding. Okay? Taano na pleasant metlaeng adi di experience nga pinagpasusuda, taano duble-duble dan tulad tati agpa susu. It is our responsibility to be advocates for breastfeeding. Alright. Now, sir, api nga minga pangririm deta advocate tayo ti breastfeeding. Api gamin nga hanga mabalinti, matempla nga gatas, kaibagada sir nga, pampasirib detoy, digikabsat ko sir, ket nakpromil idi, ket anya tinapasamak sir, ki ultimo sirib na tatatag mauyong yun. Just kidding. Idi siya kano ti ubing, I was breastfed until I was 1 year old, and then naggatgata snack syak tingga gatangan da iti pro meal. So makita yo I'm multi talented charing ngi mo susuri jay nagprom pro meal nak kano ngi di jay kabsat ko nga mesa isunati nag breast milk until 4 years old. Can you imagine ingga na upat ka tawen nagsususuna ken ni nanang ko yen na sunatatan di jay Canada. Okay, so nga na siya atapo no kasi dito bra nyo kasi adadan sa nga maka-abroad dagi jay ubing nga fully breastfed na mas successful da in life. So api nga ibagamit sa nga mas successful da in life kasi basically handa nga managsakit, awan unay ti allergies da, kadaglalo kesakit no may, when I am exposed to certain amounts of heat, when no cold, no nalamiis ko ma, when no ultimo bara, agsupot-supot na. I have allergies. Why? Mabalin nga because of the cow's milk that was given to me when I was still young. Kini adding ko ke hangagal allergies mga digis mo na Canada tata. Tagamin, awam met hamingag supot-supot. Siya ag supot-supot na. Paino, makakaanak ti ikan nga, di gina angri, kadadagi di pasayan. So, again, I have so much allergies. And that is basically, baka, pwede, probably because of the breast milk and the cow's milk that I also took when I was still an infant, when I was still a child. Okay. So again, it's good that we know the difference between the cow's milk and the breast milk para mas madali nating ma-convince yung mga nanay po na dapat sila ay magpasusu gamit ang kanilang mga susu at hindi dapat yung mga natitimpla na gatas. Alright, so now we compare the breast milk from the cow's milk. When we look at the bacterial contamination, the breast milk kasi, it has none. Konti or wala pong bacteria doon sa breast milk. Apay. Kasi po yung breast milk, it's fresh. It comes out from the mother, which is very fresh. So, hanga contaminated so nati any bacteria. But in the cow's milk, syempre may bote deta, kada may process pay deta, aduti pag naan na nga ima, iso nga, there is bacterial contamination. So, mabaling agtakpi di ubing? Yes. Alright, next. Meron din po tayong tinatawag na anti-infective substance. Yung sinasabi nating anti-infective substance, these are components that are found in the milk which can prevent infection. Dito di bagbagatay tatay nga colostrum when no immunoglobulin, di ba yung bagbagat tatay nga pampatangkin tikiret dejay. In the breast milk, there is a presence of immunoglobulin which is an anti-infective substance that prevents infection in the newborn. So maganda po yun. Tagamin at dati, immunoglobulin nga pampatangken tikiret deje ubing. But for the cow's milk, wala pong nakikitang anti-infective substances that are active. Meaning the cow's milk cannot protect the newborn from any disease. But the breast milk, since it has antibodies, it can protect the newborn from early childhood diseases. All right. Meron din tayong tinatawag na chon. Yung chon po, that is the chemical symbol for protein. Alright? The protein that is present on the breast milk, o i-mark nyo to sa board exams ha, because it comes out in the board exams. Remember this. The protein that is found on the breast milk is called lactalbumin. The protein present in the cow's milk is what we call casein. Alright? So makita nyo, 1% lang yung protein na nakukuha ni baby sa breast milk. And then sa cow's milk naman po, 4%. Kaya sir, hangarod nga na pimpintas, no? Adado ti protein nga maalaji baby? Hindi. Apay. This is the reason why the newborns who are breastfeeding kaya't napintas di takida. Formed isuna ng imhanga na tangken. Because the protein that are present in the breast milk is just adequate. Sakto-sakto lang. Ngem, no aggatas suna kadagiji matempla, wendo dagiji cow's milk, nagngato gamin ti protein content na. And because of the high levels of protein, yung bata po, nagkakaroon siya ng constipation. Isong agtabel, deje ubing. Isong napintas batig tabel, haan. Kasi mabaling nga magkaroon so natin anal fissure or masugat dejay, puriit na. There will be lacerations on the anal sphincter because of the constipated stool. Okay, the impacted stool nga natang-tangken, hangarumwar. So, napintas ba ti 4% nga protein? Hindi. Mas maganda pa rin yung lactalbumin, which is easily absorbed by the body, kasi yung protein na casein, which will cause constipation. Next, we also have amino acids, which are the building blocks of protein. In the breast milk, meron pong enough amino acids. But in the cow's milk, there is not enough amino acids or building blocks of protein. Next, sa fats po, pareho lang sila. Both of them have average of 4% fats. When you say fatty acids naman po, the breast milk, yung fat po naman nandoon sa fatty acids na, I mean, yung fatty acids po na nakakita natin sa breast milk is saturated. Saturated fats which are easy to digest. But in the cow's milk naman po, it's unsaturated fat which is also very difficult to digest. Kita yung nagsidakati nakakarkarnikin nakatabtaba, itamkit agtabil ka. Same principle with your cow's milk and breast milk. Next, we also have your lipase. Your lipase are enzymes that are best for metabolism because they help break down several components in the body for metabolism. Now, in the breast milk, adda apo ti lipase. So nga, nadardaras apo ti metabolism di ubing. Ngayon, for the cow's milk, there is none. Wala pong lipase doon. So meaning, mahihirapang mag-metabolize ti newborn kasi wala siyang enzymes that are responsible for metabolism. Meron ding sodium. Alam nyo yung sodium? Detoy ket pampaumbal. Okay, sodium. So, ngayon may parit aputi agsi dati na aapgad, dagidid dati high blood na kadaglalok because sodium will increase the likelihood of edema, umbal. Okay? In sodium, when we talk about sodium in the breast milk, there is approximately 6.5 grams per deciliter, basit. But when you compare it to the cow's milk, apo adaduti sodium na dejay, 25 grams per deciliter. So nga, dagidyo ubing nga, agdedede using cow's milk or bottle milk, api nga kasi na nagluluumig da kung kunayo. But that's not actually healthy kasi umumbal dagidyay. Kasi nga, meron silang sodium contents. Mataas yung sodium contents ng iniinom nila. Whereas in the breast milk, 6.5 grams per deciliter lang. So makita yung jikadakkel na. You also have your chloride. Same lang, almost half or more than half. 12 grams per deciliter for chloride in the breast milk and then 29 grams per deciliter in the cow's milk. So makita yun yung sodium and chloride nagkangato. Sodium chloride is asin. So napapgad ka no dejay cow's milk which is bad for the newborn because it can lead to edema. Now, when we talk about iron contents, iron apo detafe, okay? Fe means iron. When we talk about iron contents, may small amount lang ang breast milk. but it is well absorbed by the body. Okay? In the cow's milk naman po, meron bang iron? Yes, meron ding iron. It is small in amount, but it is poorly absorbed by the body. So judging on this chart alone, judging on this table alone, makikita natin po how good breast milk is compared to bottle milk or cow's milk. So kung nadangarod, ang gatas ng ina ay para dapat sa bata. At ang gatas ng baka ay dapat para sa baka. So nga hindi po natin dapat pinapadede yung mga newborn ng gatas ng baka kasi hindi naman po sila baka. Alright? Next, we also talk about the care of the eyes. I think this is going to be my last discussion kasi we've been having this session for more than an hour already. Baka meron pa kayong gagawin. We have the care of the eyes or what we call eye prophylaxis. Ito pong eye prophylaxis na to, it is also known as your Creed's prophylaxis, and it was invented in the year 1884. It's given to prevent gonorrheal conjunctivitis. Did you gonorrheal conjunctivitis coming from the word gonorrhea, which is a sexually transmitted disease? No, did you gamin causative agent mapantiyan ti mata mabaling agkosunati blindness ka did you ubing? Okay? Always remember that infants who pass the birth canal, okay, may have their eyes contaminated coming from the discharges of the vagina, which will cause neonatal blindness or ophthalmia neonatorum. Okay? Apay kaso nung mapaspasamak detoy. Lagi penyo de gonorrhea is a sexually transmitted disease. STD suna weno STI. Tatan, dejay mother nga dati gonorrhea na, there are discharges coming from the vagina apo, dejay pepe na, adarumrumar nga discharges. These discharges, mabalin nga ano dagito yung rumrumar niya, they contain the causative agent at dati microbio na dejay. Kano na yanak dejay ubing using the vaginal, via vaginal delivery, mabalin nga dagito yung discharges mapanjimatada, which will now cause blindness. Nagsistart siya as gonorrheal conjunctivitis, lumteg di matana, until aglid to ophthalmia na yun atorum when no agbulsek. Newborn blindness, tinagan na di jay. Alright? Now always remember that this blindness can be caused by two sexually transmitted diseases. Nice, ay gonorrhea and chlamydia. Duwa di jay apo. The causative agent for gonorrhea is Neisseria gonorrhoeae, and the causative agent for chlamydia is Chlamydia trachomatis. You underline that, you highlight that because that comes out in the board exams. All right? Dagita apo ti mangkokos ti neonatal blindness, especially if they are born via normal spontaneous delivery. Now, idi ti uso sa renda is silver nitrate. This is a chemical that they mix with water and then ipatatid pa dyan yung mata dyan yung ubing. But because of technology, hindi na po natin ginagamit yan. Ang ginagamit na po natin ngayon is what we call the drug of choice or DOC, which is oxytetracycline, ophthalmic ointment. Alright? Now, detagamin silver nitrate, ilang mapatay na data is Neisseria gonorrhea. But your oxytetracycline ophthalmic ointment, it can also eliminate Chlamydia trachomatis. So anong mas magandang gamitin? Yung silver nitrate ba na isa lang yung napapatay or yung oxytetracycline ophthalmic ointment na dalawa yung napapatay ng causative agent? Malamang yung dalawa. Alright? So it's killing two birds with one stone or killing two STIs, causative agent, with one ointment. Alright. So paano po siya nilalagay? The oxytetracycline ophthalmic ointment is applied on the lower conjunctiva. Dito yung apo ti pangipanan da dejay. Okay? So what do we do is we open the eyes of the newborn by applying pressure on the upper and lower eyelids. Ikastata yung bistraden tayo matada. And then the manner of giving the drug is from inner canthus to outer canthus. Dapat po hindi nagtatouch yung tip ng ointment, yung tube ng ointment, dapat hindi mo natatouch dejay yan timatan na yung ubing kasi just in case nga infected day nga tubing at isa nga mapanjian ti mata di ubing, right? So inner to outer kanto si ibukira di nga kasta, and then you drop the ointment from inner to outer cantus, jibangir manen, ibuki radio, from inner to outer cantus of the eye. And then after that, nunay kabil yun, you close the eyes slowly to allow the ointment to spread. Agwaras to dejay. Now, kasa tichura na dejay agas, ceramycin or oxytetracycline ophthalmic ointment, gawayan ng Pfizer. Right? Kasta apo ti pinangbuki radio dejay antimatana, so makita yun ke merong fiery red yung mata ng bata. So, nagsistart na po yung kanyang gonorrheal conjunctivitis. So, makita yun ke, aglablabaga yung matanan. Alright. Oh, so, I guess that ends our discussion for this evening. And I hope that you enjoyed the class that I presented for you. I want you all to turn on your camera so that we can again have a picture taking, so that I can upload it on Facebook para po makita ng ibang mga classmates nyo, nagklase tayo ngayon. Alright? So turn on your camera. Ayan, magpaganda po. Magpaganda ng maigi. Alright, turn on your camera so that we can have a selfie. Lawag na kayong corny. And then I'll have to say goodbye. Meron naman po kayong natutunan, ano? Tumangu po, agtungid kayo na dami lang na sursuruyo. Dami lang na meron bang natutunan? Alright? So, alright. Let's turn on your camera, people, so we can have a photo opportunity. Okay? Sige. Yung mga hindi magta-turn on ng camera, mababagsak sa board exams. No, yun yun. Okay. Hoy, lo. Ilokat mo, no, Gerald. Ilokat yun. Hindi. Apo, nagpintasan ni Mr. Magin. Alright. Sige, smile. And one, two, and three. Alright, that ends our discussion. Maraming salamat again for listening and taking the time to join the class. Again, God bless and enjoy the rest of the evening. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Mitch, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.